Hey, what's up everyone and welcome to Daily Code Buffer. In this video, we are going to learn what is Express.js and how we can use it to create a web application. So let's jump into it. In this tutorial, we are going to see what is Express.js. So Express.js is a minimalist web framework for Node. So you can see here, this is the Express.js website. So it provides a very easy and intuitive way to use a HTTP request and response in the Node.js. So in the previous tutorials also, you have seen that we have used HTTP modules of Node.js, where we have created HTTP request and response, but there we have created with the help of if statements. We have created different if statements. Based on those if and else statements, we created and we routed the different request. Okay, so if we have a very big application, then it's not a convenient way to route the request. So for that, we will be using Express.js. So to install Express.js, go to the Express.js website or an npm website and search for Express. Okay, and this is the command npm install Express. We'll go to our console and run this command npm install express to install Express.js in our Node project. So you can see here Express has been installed. Okay, let's go to our project. Let's see our package.json and you can see Express has been added over here. Now let's create a first Express.js HTTP request. Like other modules, we need to add the module in our app.js. We'll add const express equals to require express. Okay, now we will instantiate the express object. Const amp equals to express. Okay, now with this app variable we can route the different request. So the same as HTTP, we'll be using app dot. So with this express we have different methods available, different HTTP methods like app dot get, okay, app dot post, app dot put, app.delete. So these are the different HTTP methods available to do the different HTTP operations like get, post, put and delete. So now we'll be using get method to do the HTTP get. Here we'll be passing our URL, which is slash, and the callback function. The callback function will take request and response as in input variables. And inside the response, we will send the data. Okay, so our request is ready. Now we need to listen to the port. So we'll be adding app.listen to the port number. Okay, here we'll be adding port 5000. Okay, now let's run the application. We'll use Node app. Okay, you can see our application started. Let's go to browser and check the application. We'll go to localhost 5000. You can see our request is served. Hello everyone, from here. Now you can see here we are using a port number which is static over here. We are defining from the application. But this is not a standard way. We should always put our port in our environment variable. So we should add our port in an environment variable and we should pick the port from that environment variable in the code and use that port. So let's see how we can add the port in our environment variable. Go to your console, okay, and set the environment variable. So in the Windows environment you can use set and in the Linux environment you can use export. So we'll use set import. Okay, so this way you can define the port. Now go to our application and here let's get the port equals to, now you can get the port from the process object. So process dot environment dot port. Okay, so this way you can get the port, and you can also add, if this port is not available, then use 5000. Okay, and now change the code to port. Okay, now add the console.log. Listening to port. Okay, so this way you can add the port over here. In the it will check in the environment variable, if the port is available, then it will select that port. Otherwise, it will start in 5000. So we'll run the application, node app. Okay, you can see that our server is started at 5000. Okay, there might be some issue with the variable I have added. Okay, but this is the way you can add the ports over here. So you would have noticed that whenever we do any changes in our node application, at the time we will stop our server and will restart our server. So that is a very tedious process to start the server and stop the server every time for every small changes we do. So for that, what we can do is we can use a node mon module of node. So it will monitor all the changes in your node files and it will reflect in your server. So for that, what we can do is we'll go to our npm and we'll search for node mon. Okay, search for your node mon, and this is the module. So you need to install this module as a globally to run this. So let's install it. Go to our console and run this command. npm install -g for global and node mon. You can see here node mon has been downloaded. Now let's go to our application. So this is the application which has slash as the root URL, and it will start on the port 5000. Okay, so when we run the application, we use node space and the app.js or the JavaScript file. Okay, instead of that, what we have to do is we need to start with node mon, okay, and app.js. So this way you can see that our node mon is started. It's been watching the entire root directory. Okay, so any changes in this root directory will be reflected. So it is watching JS, MJS and JSON file. So let's run the application. Okay, so this is our application. So let's do the changes. We'll change hello everyone from node mon. Okay, you can see that the changes will be added over here. So it's been listening. So we'll check in server. So it's been reflecting over here. So this way you can use node mon. That will help to identify the changes which have been done in your node application, and it will reflect the server accordingly. So now let's create some more routes. We'll copy this. Okay, and I'm creating one more route, that is /person, and we'll write this is person route. So this way we can add multiple routes with Express.js. If you remember, with the HTTP module we were using if blocks to define multiple routes. So this is very easy process over here. So let's check this route. We'll go to our browser and we'll do /person. Okay, you can see this is our person route. Let's see, you want to add some parameters, you want to pass some data from your browser. Okay, suppose in this person you need to pass the name of the person and the age of the person. Okay, so how you can do is let's go to our application and create the route for it. So let's copy paste this route, okay, and we'll add the request parameters. So for adding the request parameters, what we can do is we'll add forward slash and we want name, right? So we'll add name and we want age also, so forward slash colon age. This way we added the parameters. So person slash will be getting a name and slash age will be getting the age also. We can get these parameters from the request object, from request dot params object. We can get dot name and we can get by age. So let's print this request dot params in the console and check how we are getting the data. So we'll add console dot log. Let's add request dot params. Okay, and we'll send params back. Now let's check this out. We'll be passing name and age. Okay, so in with this person we'll be passing name, like we'll be passing Alex, and let's pass he's 30. Okay, you can see that we hit this particular URL and we are getting data Alex and age is 30. Okay, so this is the name and age. This would be the same as what we pass over here. So this way you can get the parameters. So there is also a query string parameters, okay, which you pass after the question mark, like group by. Group by equals to name, okay, something like that. So what is the difference between these request parameters and query string parameters is, when you have some parameters which has to be mandatory, then those will be added in the request parameters. So like for this person, I want my name and age, correct? So for that name and age, I have added as a request parameters. But after that, like I want those data by group by, or I want to add some more parameters that are optional. So that I can add in the query string parameters. So let's see how I can get the query string parameters. So just like request parameters, the query string parameters also will be getting from request object. Okay, so instead of this request parameters, let's send request dot query. So this query will return all the query parameters which are been passed from this route. Okay, so let's check it out. So if you can see here, this URL I'm passing person Alex, age 30, and group by equals to name. So I'm passing name, so it should come group by as name. Okay, so you can see here I'm passing group by as name. I can add multiple parameters as well. If I want multiple parameters, then I can add and ABC equals to XYZ. Okay, so this also I should get. So this way you can get the request parameters and query string parameters, and you can use it accordingly. But remember, request parameters for mandatory fields and query string parameters for optional fields. Once you do this, you're good to go for your building REST APIs. So in this tutorial, we will serve the static file with the help of Express.js. So you can see here, we have one index.html file. Okay, this is the one which we have created. This is a simple HTML file. So we will serve this index.html file with the help of Express. So to work with file, we need to have a path module. So let's add path module. Constant path equals to require path. Okay, now with this path, we'll create one request, app.get. Okay, we will serve when I hit index. Okay, and I have a request response parameters in my callback function. Okay, and in response dot, we will add send file. Inside this send file, we'll use path dot join method. Okay, and we need to pass the string array for joining the path. So we will add directory and the current directory, and we will add the name of the file, index.html. So in this current directory we have index.html file. So when I will hit slash index route, then index.html file should be served. Now let's run our application. We don't have to restart our server as we are using nodemon. Okay, so let's go to our browser and check. Welcome to daily code buffer. Our files are reflecting. Cool, right? So in this tutorial we will see how we can handle HTTP GET. So we'll take one example of a movies. So we will create different HTTP methods, and based on the different methods we'll be serving different purposes with just movies. We'll create a movies array, and on the request of GET we'll be passing all the movies. We'll create a new movie, we will update a movie, we'll delete a movie, and we'll return all the movies as well. So let's check that out. So let's create a route for getting all the movies. Okay, so let's create app.get and we are adding a route. So let's add slash API slash movies route. So this is a generic form. So every company or every organization, you see, every project will be using API for their particular APIs. Either they will be using API in their routes or in their domain, like api.somedomain.com/any APIs. You can use any of it. I'm just going with the norms we have. So I've created slash API slash movies. Okay, and as a callback function we'll be having request and response object. So let's say we are returning response.send array of movies, like we added Star Wars, we'll be adding Star Trek, and let's add Toy Story. Okay, I'm serving a request with these movies. Okay, so let's check it out. We'll be using slash API slash movies to serve this GET request. So we'll be using, so you can see here we are getting this data, Star Wars, Star Trek and Toy Story. So this way you can serve the GET request. So let's create an array of movies and we will work on it. Constant movies equals to, okay, so this is an array and I'll be creating movies. It will have ID and name of a movie. Okay, Star Wars. Okay, let's add some more. Okay, let's add 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's add Star Trek. Let's add Toy Story. Let's add Transformers, Terminator. Okay, so this will be enough. So let's send this movies instead of the movies which we created here. Okay, so let's send this movies object. Okay, and run our application. You can see here all our movies are coming here. Cool, right? So now let's add one more method in which we will search the movies based on the ID which we provide. Okay, currently all the movies are shown, so we'll create a method where you will pass ID and that particular movie object will be returned. Okay, so let's create app.get slash APIs slash movies. Okay, and we'll be having request and response objects and a callback function. Here we'll be passing ID, so we'll add a request parameter ID. Now we need to search the movie based on the ID which we provided and search in this particular array and return that particular object. For that, let's do let movies equals to, we'll add a movie, right? We'll get a one movie. So we'll be getting from movies, right? So movies dot find. So inside this find, we need to pass a parameter c. We can get any c, a function. So c dot id, which we'll be getting, should be equals to request dot params dot id, which we are getting here. Okay, and let's pass it to int. Okay, so that it can be matched correctly. If we got a movie, then we can send it directly, and if we didn't get a movie, we need to send a message like we didn't get any movie. So if we didn't get a movie, then response dot send, we can add no movie found for the id. Let's change it to grave accent. Okay, request dot params dot id. So no movie found for the id, this. Else response dot send movie. So you got it right. We'll be having slash api slash movies and slash id. This id we will use to search the movie from this list, and accordingly we will send the data. So let's run this. We'll go to our browser. We have slash api slash movies and we will pass 3, so we should get Toy Story. Okay, we are getting Toy Story. If we pass anything else like 5, we should get Terminator. Okay, now if we pass anything which is not available, which is 10, we should get no movie found for id 10. So this is how you handle your HTTP GET methods. In this tutorial, we will see how we can create a movie and post it using the HTTP post request. In the previous tutorial, we saw how to use app.get. So here we will see how we can use app.post and we can use HTTP post methods to add a movie into our array which we created. So basically, in the real world application, we'll be using databases for these activities. But as of now, to simplify everything, we are focusing only on Express.js now and Node.js. So we have removed the every other aspect of it. So let's create app.post method and see how we can handle it. So we'll be getting post data in the JSON format. Our Express.js has to justify or has to understand like all our data coming from our browser or our request has to convert into JSON, and then we can use those JSON from the request object. So for that, we need to add one middleware for it. So let's add it. We can use app.use, okay, and express.json. So what it will do is, this is the middleware which we are using. So every request and every data which has been passed will be passed to this middleware and convert into JSON format, and then will be added to the request. So whatever data we'll be getting in request will be getting in JSON format. That would be easy for us to use the data. So now let's create one more route, app.post. Okay, so we'll be posting the data from the client and we'll be getting in our server. So app.post will be passing slash API slash movies. Okay, and we have our request and response objects. Now let's create a movie object. Okay, let movie equals to, so from the post we will be passing the name of the movie only. We won't be passing id, because if you see the database, the id will be generated automatically. Here what we will do, we will increment the value of the id based on the length of the array. So the id attribute, how we will see, is movie dot length plus 1. So we are incrementing the value and the name property. So the name property will be getting from our request, request dot body dot name. Okay, so our movie object is created. Now we need to push this movie object to our movies. So we'll do movies dot push and we'll push our movie object. Okay, now we'll send the particular movie object back to our response. So response dot send movie. Okay, app dot post slash api slash movies. We are sending a movie name, we are creating a movie object over here. The id we are generating based on the size of the array, we are passing name from the request dot body dot name, and we are adding the movie object to our array and we are passing that to our response. Now to serve this post request, you need to have any client. Okay, so for that I am using Postman to serve these HTTP methods. You can use any of the client as per your choice. So let's open Postman and there we'll see how we can post the data to this particular route. So let's open Postman. Okay, let's create a new request, which is localhost colon 3000 slash API slash movies. Okay, so this is our route. We'll change from get to post as we are doing HTTP post. We'll go to our body, we'll change to raw data and text to JSON as we will be passing JSON data. So in this JSON data, we are passing name, right? So we'll be passing name of the movie. Let's add Frozen. So when we hit send, this data should be added to the movie array which we have. Okay, let's serve this. We'll click on send and you can see we are getting the object back. And when we see our array get method, and we'll be serving the same slash API slash movies, and click on send, we can see that we are getting Frozen added to our list. So this way you can use Postman to serve the HTTP request. In this tutorial, we are going to see how we can do input validations. Never trust the data which is coming from the request. So there might be any chance like data won't be good enough, or data might be missing, or data might be corrupted. So it's always a good practice to do a validation at our server side. So let's do the validation for the name of the movie which we are getting. So let's check if the name is present and the size of the name should be greater than 4 characters, or let's say 3 characters, because some movie name might be of 3 characters, right? So let's add the validation. So we'll add if request.body.name, okay, or request.body.name.length is less than 3, okay, then I should throw an error. Okay, so at that time what I should do, I should send response.status 400, which is bad request, dot send, and we'll be sending the name of movie is not present or less than 3 characters. Okay, and once this is done, we'll do return. We don't have to execute the code anymore. Okay, so this will check if name is not there or less than 3 characters, we are validating the data. We are not adding to our movies array. So let's validate this. Let's remove the data over here. Okay, we'll be serving the blank request in our body. We'll change the get to post and we will hit the send. You can see we're getting the name of movie is not present or less than 3 characters. So this way you can do the validation. But this is a very simple validation. We have just added for one name. In a real world example, we'll be getting a plethora of data from the request, and the validation would also be complex. So to do all those validations, we should not handle this with this method. We should use some of the modules or some of the libraries provided by Node. So here we'll be using Joy module for doing the validation. So let's go to npm and search for Joy. Okay, so this is the command to install. So let's open command prompt and install Joy. So you can see here Joy has been installed. Okay, so we need to add this const Joy equals to require Joy. So how this Joy works is, once we add the Joy, we need to create a schema for the validation. What schema is? Schema is the meta information for the data which we have. So it will define what type of data we would be having and what are the different attributes for it. So in this, our post method, we'll be defining that schema and we can use that schema for the validation. So let's create a schema. Constant schema equals to joi dot object. Okay, inside that object we need to validate name property, right? So we'll be having name, and that should be of type string, should be of minimum 3 characters, and it is required. Okay, you can add multiple fields if you have multiple fields. I don't have, so I'm just giving you with this simple example. Now once this is done, you need to validate the schema against the request.body. So let's validate at schema.validate, and you need to pass request.body. Okay, so this will validate the data. Let's store this validation to our result. Okay, and let's print those result. Okay, console.log result. So this schema will be validated against the request body which we have over here. Okay, so it will validate, it should be required, name should be required, and it should be of minimum 3 characters, and it's of type string. So result will be stored and will be printed in logs. So let's run the application. So we'll go to a postman and let's add some movie. Okay, let's add Fast 5. Okay, now when I enter this movie is added. Okay, now let's do one thing, we will give some error. Before that, if we see in our console, you can see that value is printed over here, okay, from the result attribute. So if value is there, there is no error. If error is there, then value object would be null and the error will be populated. So let's see that. Let's say we are not passing anything over here, okay, and we are hitting send. You can see here value is null and the error we are getting, name is required from the JOI. Okay, if we add less than 3 characters, okay, it should give the same. Okay, it's of 2 characters, name length must be at least 3 characters long. So this way we can do the validation. Let's add those things over here. So let's remove this block. We'll add if result dot error, then we'll send response dot status 400, and we'll send result dot error dot details of 0 dot message. So the message which is there will be sending back. Okay, and we'll add return statement, so no need to execute afterward. So we added the validation with the help of this schema. Okay, so let's check this. We'll go here and let's try this out again. You can see here we're getting the name of movie is not present or less than 3 characters. So the validation has been working from Joy schemas. So this way you can add different validations based on the different schemas and the different request body parameters you have. So in this tutorial we will see how to handle HTTP put requests to update the data. So here we'll be updating movies. So we'll be passing an ID which movie should be updated and the movie object as well. To what name should we update? So let's write the route for that. So we'll be writing app.put / API / movies, and we'll be passing request and response. We need to pass the param also, that will be passing ID over here. Okay, now what our logic would be here is we need to find the movie based on ID. Okay, if not found throw error, if found need to update. We need to do validation for the request. Once validated, update the movie object and then return that movie. So this is the logic which we need to write. Okay, so let's add the code. We already have this written in our get route to find the movie. We also have done this to validate the object which we are getting. After that we just need to add the updation of that particular movie. So let's copy the code from there. So from here let's find the movie. Okay, and we'll write this code also. Okay, we don't need this. Okay, so if we got the movie, now we should do the validation. So let's get the schema, the result, the log and the validation. Okay, let's do all these things. So we created the schema, we have name should be string, minimum of 3, the same as we did in post. We are doing the validation over here. If it's error then we are returning. If there is no error then we need to update that movie object, right? Then movie dot name should be equals to request dot body dot name. So our movie object is updated and we should send this back. Fine, right? Find the movie, do the validation, if error throw the error, update the object and send the object. So let's run this again. Okay, we'll go over here. Okay, let's do get. Okay, we have these objects. Let's update the first one. Okay, we'll change the get method to put, we'll pass one and we'll pass the name as Star Wars 2. Okay, click on send. So you can see here it's working, it changed to Star Wars 2. So this way you can do the put method. So you can see here our code is little bit messed up because every time we cannot create the schemas and do the validation, right? The code is repeated. So for that what you can do is you can create a different method for it and you can pass the logic over here to validate and everything. So this way our code would be modularized. So you can create this validation method by your own, and if you have any issues let me know in the comment section. So I'll be replying your comments if you have any issues on that. So in this tutorial we will see how to handle delete HTTP request. Okay, we already completed get, post and put. Now we'll go to delete. We'll be passing the ID of which the movie should be deleted. So if we pass 1, the ID with 1, that movie should be removed from our array. So we'll use app dot delete method. This will be passing our route slash API slash movies, and we have request and response objects. Okay, and here our logic would be find the movie based on ID. Okay, for that we need to pass the ID over here also. Okay, slash ID. So find the movie based on ID. If not present, throw the error. If present, find the index of the object in array. Okay, remove that object from that index. So this should be our logic for removing the movie. So let's do it. We have this particular thing over here, so let's get this. Okay, now we got the movie. Now we need to find the index. So we'll do constant index equals to movies dot index of the object which is there, which is movie. Okay, now we got the index, right? Now with this we need to remove the object from the array. So we'll be using splice method to remove the object from the array. So we'll be using movies dot splice method. We'll be passing index and the number of elements to remove. So want to remove that first element, the one element. Okay, so this should remove that particular element from the movies. And after that, response dot send particular movie. So let's run this out. So we'll go over here and we'll change to delete method. Okay, so let's say we want to remove the first one, which is Star Wars. We'll click on send. You can see this, we are returning the one object, so that means this object has been deleted from the array. So if you see get method and we remove this, so the first object no longer exists in the array. Okay, so in this tutorial we are going to see what is middleware and how to create a middleware. Okay, in the previous tutorial we saw that we added app.use express.json. okay, when we were working with post and put. So what this was doing was, this was a middleware which was converting our object and it was parsing the JSON data. That was a middleware between the request sent and the request reaching to our route. So that is a middle thing which we're handling. So if you want to create a custom middleware, how we can create is, we need to use app.use, then we'll be having our request and response objects. Okay, now here we need to define the next method which will be called. So we are passing a next, which will be a method serving as a middleware, will be working. So here we'll define, so this is our middleware created. So let's call this next method. Okay, now let's say you want to do something over here. Okay, let's say I'll print what is the request URL and what is the request dot method over here in the logs. Okay, so whenever there is a request to any of the routes, like this one or this one, any of the routes, then it will come to this particular middleware first. Okay, and then this will be executed, and after that our request will be transferred to the route. So let's run this. So let's go to our browser and let's check slash movies. Okay, you can see all our movies are coming, but if you go to our console, you can see that we hit /api/movies and the method was get. So our middleware is working. Now if you want your middleware to be working on any of the particular route only, then also you can do that. Like I want my route to be working only when there is a /api/movies. Okay, so at that time my middleware will be working, and if I hit this request, then my middleware won't work. So let's check this. So let's do this. Okay, you can see that my object is coming. Okay, and you can see that /api/movies/1 and get, it's coming. Now we hit only slash. Okay, then you can see nothing is printed. So that means my middleware is only working for this particular route. So this way you can create your different routes based on the requirement for your application. So whatever you want to do before the request is hit to the route, the middleware will be helpful. So in this tutorial we are going to see what is express routes. So in this current application you can see here we have added lot of different routes over here, and our application is really messy because right now it's only 5 to 6 routes available, but in the production grade application there will be thousands and thousands of different routes available. Okay, so at that time to modularize all these different routes will be very essential. So what we can do, we can create different routes based on the different functionalities, and we can create a main route file that will be having all the different routes added to it. So let's create one example. Let's create one route and add it to the main file. Okay, so let's create movies route. Okay, movies.js. okay, so this is our module. So let's add constant express equals to require express, and then we'll create a route, constant route equals to express.route. okay, so our route variable is created. Now we need to define all the different routes over here. So let's do one thing, let's get all these particular movies from here, okay, and add it over here. Let's change every app to route. Okay, so all our changes from app we have changed to movies. Now we need to export this route so that we can use it in our app.js. okay, so let's export module.exports equals to route. Okay, so this route is exported and we can use this in our app.js. we need to add that movies module over here. Okay, so let's add constant movies equals to require movies. Okay, we have added our movies module over here. Now we need to add the routes which we are using over here to be used by this app. Okay, so let's add app.use. okay, and we need to define one route for it. Let's say we are defining ABC route for our movies. Okay, and our object would be movies. So this way we can define the different routes over here. We currently define this movie route in our app.js with /abc. Oh, this is still here. Let's add this in movies. Okay, now we can see here we don't have anything related to movies over here. Obviously this constant is required there, right? So all movies related things are clear. We have movie, we have added to our route as well. So now let's hit the server and check. So you can see now we cannot use directly /api/movies how we were using previously. we need to use /abc/api/movies to hit this route. Okay, so let's go to our browser and check. So previously we are using this thing, so we'll be using now /abc/api/movies. Okay, you can see all our data is coming over here. Okay, with /abc/movies, you can use this as well. So this way you can use different routes, express routes in your application. So this we created only for movies. So if you have multiple things, you can create different routes. You can add those routes over here. So this will be a very easy process. If you have made this far, thank you and congratulations to you on completing this course. We have made so much efforts in creating this free course for you. So please subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get notified for future videos and support us. Also, if you got any value from this course, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions related to any topic covered, let us know in the comment section below. We will answer all your queries. And thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next tutorial.